Well, I am Jane Jenkins Herlong. I am a Southern humorist. And this is one of my first live presentations on the heels of COVID. So I combine Southern humor, because that's what I do, and music. So what I have done is a little bit of a montage of my humor, plus the singing, plus the music I've been working on. So I hope you enjoy it. And this is what meeting planners hire me for, is to inject some fun, because I think we need encouragement and humor these days. I'm a professional singer, always fun to use music. So this is what you'll see in this video, and I hope you enjoy it.
All the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough, never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it would never be enough, never be enough for me, never, never, never. A million dreams, it's all it's gonna take. We can rewrite the stars, and this world would be ours. We will make.
Remember the first time you wore your mask to the grocery store? Did y'all feel like you were just going to suffocate right there? I mean, I'm going, I can't do this. And I gained great respect for our medical community. I'm telling you. But here was the worst. You got this thing on your face. You can't breathe. And you're going down the paper aisle. And all of a sudden you see blank shelves. And you think, what are we going to do? And then your brain kicks into another gear. And then you spot it. You say, there it is, coffee filters. And then there's some commercial about it's good to the last drop. I don't know if that's a filter, but it's close enough. But isn't it funny? I mean, what are people going to say about us? I think about that. And of course, you know, call our friends. I have a girlfriend. She said, I'm just freaking out, Jane. I ran out of hand sanitizer. I said, girl, you can make that. She said, I'm a horrible cook. I said, come on. You just need alcohol and aloe vera. Just mix it together. She said, that just sounds complicated to me. So I called her up. I said, how'd it go? She said, not good. But it ended up being okay at the end because I just made myself a margarita. And I just got so tired of seeing how to make a mask. You know, I got sick of that because I'm not good. I'm domestically disabled. Yeah, so I brought a little YouTube video of me making a mask with no scissors and no thread. Okay. So when I went to get dressed upstairs,
that's where I left my Spanx. So that's why I got this on, this little hoo-ha.
Oh, yeah. You had to have a sense of humor through it all. Respectfully, you really did. And so I've been thinking about all these new folks moving in. Y'all know we got a whole bunch of new people. I mean, they're just all over. They are. They're coming in droves. Bless their little hearts. Yep. And I met a couple. They're from California. And I said to him, I said, well, tell me, how you like living in the South? He said, we love it, but we can't understand the way y'all talk. He said, I went to the water authority and got up to the lady, and she handed me all these papers, and she's a real sweet country lady. She said, now, see these papers right here? You take them over yonder. He said, excuse me, over what? She said, yonder. He said, ma'am, I'm sorry, I don't know where yonder is. She said, you from California, aren't you? You ain't used to the way we talk down here. Let me explain it to you. Over yonder is any place where you ain't. I thought that was pretty good. Then I started thinking about people in my own life that really handled things well. And I got to tell you about my cousin Teta. I just loved her because she had a fabulous sense of humor. And she was a school teacher. And she taught school for 42 years. And you would think everybody would be, yay, Teta, you did great. But there was this one parent that walked up to her with their fist in her face just like this and said, lady, I got a good mind to knock your teeth down your throat. She said, you know, I'll save you the trouble. She took out her dentures. She did. And when I was writing the fifth book, Sweet Tea Secrets from the Deep Fried South, I got a call from my publisher. And they said, Jane, you need to add on to the Teta story. We need some more copy. So I called a couple of my friends. I said, y'all got any Teta stories in the low country? I said, oh, yeah. You know, she loved to cook breakfast for her family. And she's an old school Southern mom. And so she goes and tries to get some eggs, and nothing's there. So she went to the chicken house. You know, people had chicken houses back then. So she heard all this squawk, 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 clack, clack, you know, all this crazy stuff. And she knew she had an intruder. And she walked in, and there was the skinny, long intruder with three big lumps. And she said, those are my eggs. She took off her shoes. She held that snake upside down and literally wiggled those three eggs the opposite direction. Honey, she threw that snake in the woods and gathered those eggs and fixed breakfast for her family. And that is a true story.